Here we are at Eurovision You Decide Meet the Artists, and next up is Jazz Ellington. Hello and welcome.
Hello.
Your song is You. Mm-hmm. And how did the song come about? Were you sent it? Did you decide on it? How did it work?
The song was sent to me in December. Really loved it, so I thought, let's do it.
Okay. Was it an instant? Did you have to choose?
Instant. It was, you know, when it's almost like playing Tetris and that perfect piece comes down to complete the line, do you know what I mean? It's definitely a me song.
Okay. So it's obviously your styling, that what you normally do. Obviously, the styling of the song is fairly different compared to the other five.
Yeah.
Do you feel that's a good thing, or do you think that's a bad thing?
You know what? It's a bit of both. I mean, my song is definitely a wild card. It's not a standard Eurovision entry kind of stylistic track. But I like stuff like that sometimes, you know, just to break the mold. And, you know, maybe it'll be different. Maybe the UK public will actually see, oh, let's try this one. You know, something, a little bit of change. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. So what is your history in music? How did this become your profession?
I've been surrounded by music since I was young. I remember being able to sing when I was really young. So in school, singing assemblies, I was called to the front to sing. I was always picked to do roles in, you know, plays and stuff that had loads of singing and stuff. I was went to school, studied GCSE, music, got A star. quit school, more singing, went on to do The Voice. And since then, I'm a vocal arranger. I run choirs, I do vocal lessons, I think I said vocal arrange already, but I said vocal arrange. My world is surrounded by music and singing. If I didn't like singing, I'd be in trouble. So.
Fair enough. Obviously you do have a platform, obviously, from The Voice. Obviously Eurovision is The Voice times 10.
Thousands.
Yeah. Do you find that daunting, or do you find that exciting?
Daunting, if I'm being honest with you. It'd be very silly of me to say, yo, it's easy, piece of cake, let's do it. No, it's definitely nerve-wracking, the thought of all those eyes on you. But I'm going to channel that into, let's just do it and get on with it. You know what I mean?
Fair enough.
You know, it's amazing. It's an amazing platform, and such an honour. So there's more of me that's like, oh, come on, let's do it. I would love the opportunity to represent my country. That's like the biggest honour in singing, I think.
The song You is a... it's sort of a reverse love song. It's about heartbreak. And do you feel that in the 3 minutes that you have to present it, it's going to resonate with people? Do people are going to understand it? Because I love the song, but I feel it takes a few listens to get really into the bones of it.
Fully. I suppose, you know, that whole thing of, you know, when a song's live, it's a different... different experience. I'd like to think that will kick in. I'd like to think that a lot of people can relate to the song in terms of what the words are saying. I'm sure we've all been in a situation like that, in that kind of, or some of us are in that situation, you never know. So I'd like to think that maybe I can depend on relatability and the styling and me just being soulful and honest.
So, last question. How would you stand out on stage? Is it going to be a very simple performance, or is it going to be something a bit more Eurovision-y?
That will be telling. I can't do that. You got 1 week.
Well, best of luck. We will be there on Wednesday, rooting you on at the Brighton Dome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.